Good morning, class. So, in previous session, we have learned about the direct proportion. Let us take one example over here. Suppose the cost of one pen is rupees 10. Okay, then cost of two pen is rupees 20. Then cost of three pen will be rupees 30. Okay, you can see here as the number of pen increases, the cost related to the pen also increases. If we take number of pen is equal to x and cost is equal to y, we can say here that as x increases, y also increases. Means both the quantity are related to each other. As one increases, other also increases. So this type of proportion was called as direct proportion. Okay, so where x upon y comes to one constant value k. Okay, here x was directly proportional to y. Okay, so here this was direct proportion. Now what if we can take another example here. Suppose let us take one example here, another example. Suppose total number of chocolate, total chocolate is total, suppose it is 12. Okay, 12 chocolates are there. If 12 chocolate is distributed among 2 people, okay, so each one will get 6. Okay, the number of people, suppose it is x, and each one will get 6, so amount. Okay, so this is y. If it is distributed among 3 people, how many each will get? 4. Okay, if it is distributed among 6 people, it will get, they will get 2. Okay, if it is distributed among 12, each one will get 1. So here you can see that as number of people increases, each person will get less chocolate. Okay, so you can consider as x increases, y decreases. So this type of proportion is called inverse proportion. Okay, it is called inverse proportion. Here you can see that x and y are in inverse proportion. Okay, x and y in inverse proportion in such a way that product of both the quantity x and y comes to a constant value k. Okay, product of both the quantity gives one constant value k. Okay, so now I think you all are clear with the direct proportion and inverse proportion. Now we will solve exercise 13.2. Exercise 13.2, question number 1. Which of the following are in inverse proportion? Okay, here you will find out where the two related quantity are in inverse relation. Okay, so here first is number of workers on a job and the time complete and the time taken to complete the job. Okay, now here if one person complete the job in 10 hours, okay, agar ek banda koi bhi kaam karne ke liye 10 hours le raha hai. So if hum log number of workers bada denge, to obviously they will complete the work in early hours. Okay, they will complete the work more early, more faster. Okay, if one person is taking 10 hours, the two people will take 5 hours. Okay, they will do it faster. So here we can say that this proportion is in inverse proportion. Means number of worker increases, the time taken to complete the job decreases. Okay, so here it is an inverse proportion. Okay, next, the time taken for a journey and a distance traveled in a uniform speed. Okay, now suppose here the thing is the speed is uniform. Okay, at 100 speed only the car is running. अच्छा, तो क्या है टाइम टेकन फॉर अ जर्नी, अगर वो 10 मिनट्स में 20 किलोमीटर्स कवर कर रही है, देन इन 20 मिनट्स आल्सो इट विल कवर 40 किलोमीटर्स. सो मींस इट इज यूनिफॉर्मिटी इज मेंटेन. 10 मिनट में 20 किलोमीटर कंप्लीट करा, फिर 20 मिनट्स में 40 किलोमीटर. मींस वन क्वांटिटी इज इंक्रीजिंग, द अदर रिलेटेड क्वांटिटी आल्सो इंक्रीजिंग. सो इट इज नॉट एन इनवर्स प्रोपोर्शन. ओके, नेक्स्ट, एरिया ऑफ कल्टीवेटेड लैंड एंड द क्रॉप हार्वेस्टेड. ओके, जितना एरिया होगा क्रॉप हार्वेस्ट होगा, जितना आप क्रॉप Here see, 100 kilometer is your fixed journey. Okay, this is your fixed journey. अगर आप 100 की स्पीड से जा रहे हैं, okay, if your speed is 100 kilometer per hour, you will go there in half 30 minutes, okay? 30 minutes you will go there. If your speed is 50 kilometer per hour, you will reach there in 60 minutes. If your speed is 20 kilometer per hour, you will take more extra time, okay? One above 1 hour. 1 hour 20 minutes. So here you can see that as the speed decreases, the time increases. Okay, if you increase the speed, the time also here become less. So here you can see that the both the quantity are in inverse relation. So this is the example of inverse proportion. Next question. The population of a country and the area of a land per person. ठीक है. Here also land जो भी है, whatever the area of the land is fixed. Okay. If the people are less, if 10 people are there and 100 square kilometer, the 100 square meter, whatever it is, the area is there. Thus, तो क्या 100 है, तो each will get 100 square meter. But if the number of people increases, the area what it will get will be less. So here, this example is also of inverse proportion. Okay, as number of people increases, the land per person decreases. So let us go for the next question. Question number 2, here the question number 2 is, in a television game show, the prize money of rupees 1 lakh is to be divided equally among the winners. You find out whether the prize money given to the winner is directly proportional or inversely proportional to the number of winners. Okay. So let us here, we will consider here, let the prize money for each of the winner be Y. Okay. And we will consider as number of winner as x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, and here we will consider as y1, y2, y3, y4, and y5. Okay, like this. Okay, so here you can see as the money, well, one person is there, it is 1 lakh rupees, and when it is 2 person, okay, when the lakh rupees is divided in 2 people, it becomes 50,000. Okay, so here you can see that here the proportion is inverse. Okay, here as number of person increases, the price money decreases. Okay, so here we can say that it is an inverse proportion. We can write here, so this is the inverse proportion, and further we can write that let price money is equal to Y. Okay, as it is an inverse proportion, so here we can say that for first we will take for 1 into lakh, so we can write here. So 1 into 1 lakh is equal to 4 into Y. We consider this as Y. So now calculating what we will have, so here we will write here as Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4 and Y1. This will be our assumption and we will solve it out. So here Y1 is there. So what we will have? So Y1 is equal to, Y is equal to 1 lakh divided by 4. We can cancel here. 3 zero as it is, 4 into 1 is 4, and 4 into 25 is 100. So 25,000 rupees. Okay, so here our Y1 is 25,000. Next, 1 into 1 lakh is equal to 5 into Y2. Therefore, Y2 is equal to 1 lakh divided by 5. Okay? 3 zero as it is, 5 into 1 is 5, 20 into 5 is 100. So it is 20,000. Okay, so our Y2 is 20,000. divided by 8. So here you can split 1 lakh. So it is 8 into 1 is 8, and 125 into 8 is 1000. Okay, so the remaining is 2 zeros. So we have 12,500. So amount for 8 people is 12,500. What about if there are 10 people? Okay, so 1 into lakh is equal to 10 into y4. Therefore, y4 is equal to lakh divided by 10. So 10 cancel here, so it comes to 10,000. Okay, so when there are 10 people, the amount will come, will decrease to 10,000. Next is 25, what is 20? So my 1 into lakh is equal to 20 into y5. Therefore, y5 is equal to lakh divided by 20. So 20 into 1 is 20 and 20 into 5 is 100. So it comes to 5000. So here 20 people and the amount is rupees 5000. So here we are finished with the question number 2. So let us solve next question. Next, question number 3. The question is, Rahman is making a wheel using spokes. He wants to fix equal spokes in such a way that the angles between any pair of consecutive spokes are equal. Help him by completing the following table. Here you can see
degree.
decreases. So it is an inverse proportion. Next, calculate the angle between the pair of consecutive spokes on wheel with 15 spokes. Okay, what if there are, here it was 12, but what if there are 15 spokes? Okay, here 15 spokes are there, so what will be the answer? So here we will have x1 into y1 is equal to x2 into y2. So our x1 and y1 is 4 into 90 is equal to 15 into y. Therefore, y is equal to 4 into 90 divided by 15. So here we have 15 into 1 is 15, 15 into 6 is 90. So it is 24 degrees. So when there are 15 spokes, the angle between the two consecutive spokes is 24 degrees. Okay? Question number next, third is, how many spokes would be needed if the angle between the pair of consecutive spokes is 40? Okay, here now what is given? Now angle is given and you have to find out the number of spokes. So now here the angle between the spoke is given, that is 40 degrees, and you have to find out the x number. So now here we already know that it is in inverse proportion. So x1 into y1. So 4 into 90. So here it will be our x. So x into 40. Therefore, we will solve the number. So therefore, what we have? X equal to 4 into 90 divided by 40. So 4 into 10. And 10 into 9 is 90. So where there are number of spoke, nine. Clear? So moving to